kids, I am Chandrima. Welcome to SDSC Education. We will learn something really exciting today. Today we will learn a new chapter. The chapter name is Part of Plant. So don't waste time and let's start. Plants may be of different shapes and sizes, but they are made up of similar parts. Each part plays an important role in helping the plants to live and grow. A plant has two main parts, the root system and the shoot system. The part of the plant which grows below the soil is called the root system. The parts of the plant which grow above the soil is called shoot system. The shoot has stem, branches, leaves, fruits and flowers. Let us discuss about the various parts of a plant and the functions they perform. Roots generally grow below the ground. Plants can have either a taproot system or a fibrous root system. A taproot is a large thick root that grows straight down from a plant in order to collect water and minerals from deep in the soil. It has small roots branches out of it. Examples: the plant with taproot are radish, carrot, mustard and beans. Fibrous root system is composed of a branch of small branching roots that grow outward from the plant. They do not go deep into the soil. Grass, rice, wheat and onion are some common plants with fibrous root. Stem is the main part of the shoot system and grows above the ground. The other basic parts of a plant, namely leaves, flowers and fruits, grows on the stem. Stem can be soft or hard, weak or strong. Trees such as mango and neem have thick, hard and strong stem known as trunk. Shrubs are short woody plants with several streams growing near the ground. Rose is the name of shrubs. Herbs are the plant with soft and tender stem. They are generally shorter than shrubs. Coriander and mint are the example of herbs. Climbers are plants with weak streams that need some support to grow upright. For example, money plant. Pumpkin and watermelon plants have very weak and soft stem. These plants creep along the ground as they grow and are called creepers. Now kids, important function of the stem are: it provides support for the plant and keeps it upright. It allows the leaves to reach sunlight that they need to provide and produce food. It carries food from the leaves to all parts of the plant. It carries water and nutrients absorbed by the root to the leaves and other parts of the plant. Stem of some plants store food and are eaten as vegetables. Potato, ginger and sugar cane are the example of such types of stem. Leaves are of different shapes and size. They are arranged in different way in different plants. Look at the picture kids. The flat part of a leaf is called the leaf blade. In the middle of the leaf there is a main vein. The main vein is connected to thin tubes are called venous. The main vein and the side vein can be seen on the leaf blade. Water and minerals are carried through this vein. The stalk connects द लीफ ऑफ द स्टीम और द ब्रांच. द पॉइंटेड पर्सन ऑफ द लीफ इज कॉल्ड द टिप. द लीफ ब्लेड हैज टाइनी होल्स ऑन द अंडर साइड कॉल्ड द स्टोमाटा. द लीफ टेक इन एयर थ्रू द स्टोमाटा. इट ऑल्सो गिव आउट एक्सेस वाटर थ्रू द स्टोमाटा. नाउ किड्स वी लर्न इम्पॉर्टेंट फंक्शन ऑफ द लीव्स. लीव्स आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द किचन और द फूड फैक्ट्री ऑफ द प्लांट. ग्रीन लीव्स एब्जॉर्ब लाइट फ्रॉम द सन. Leaves take in carbon dioxide from the air through stomata and use the water that is absorbed by the root for making food. The process by which green leaves prepare food using carbon dioxide, water and sunlight is called photosynthesis. Non-green plants like mushrooms cannot make their own food. Leaves give out oxygen during the process of making food, which is essential for all living things. This is why we say that plants clean the air. Leaves of some plants store food. Cabbage, spinach, and mint are some leafy vegetables we eat. Seeds are generally tiny, such as gin, or big like that of a kidney beans. Seeds are found in various colors. Each seed has an outer covering called the seed coat that protects the seed. The seed coat is hard. The seed has a baby plant in it. The seed leaves provide food for the baby plant. When the seed get enough air, water and warmth or sunlight, a tiny plant called the seedling grows out. The process of growth of a seedling from a seed is called germination. So kids, go through, learn the chapter, and any doubt and queries, send comment and subscribe my channel.